1 over 3 area of the base times height gives you the volume of a square pyramid. But where does the formula come from? First, we'll create a pyramid with a square base and fill in its volume. Next, we divide the height of the pyramid into equal vertical slices, and we use this as a reference to build a step pyramid. Now, a very important thing to notice about the step pyramid is that the more slices it has, the closer it gets to the shape of the square pyramid. And if the step pyramid has an infinite amount of slices, then the volume of the step pyramid is equal to the volume of the square pyramid. So let's derive a formula for the volume of a step pyramid with an arbitrary amount of slices. First, we will be numbering the slices from top to bottom, and we label the bottom slice with the letter N. Next, we can see that the step pyramid is actually made up of rectangular prisms. So let's take a look at one of the prisms, and remember that its volume is equal to length times width times height. Since the base of each prism is actually a square, then the length and width are the same. Therefore, the volume is equal to length times height. So now we have a general formula for volume of a rectangular prism. But we must find a specific formula that applies to all the prisms that make up the step pyramid. First, we begin by looking at the height of the pyramid. And remember, we divided the height into equal vertical slices. Mathematically, this is represented as height divided by the number of slices, which we simplify as h over n. Therefore, each slice has a height of h over n, which is actually the height of each rectangular prism. Next, we look at the length of the pyramid, and we divide the length of the base by the same number of slices as the height. So we have length of the base divided by the number of slices, which we simplify as l over n. Therefore, each slice has a length of l over n. Now, if we line up all the rectangular prisms at one end, we can see that the first prism has a length of l over n. Looking at the second prism, its length is l over n plus l over n, which simplifies to 2l over n. And the third prism has a length of 3l over n. As we continue, the length of each prism increases in the same pattern all the way down to the last prism, which has a length of n times l over n. Therefore, the length of each prism depends on the prism number. So the length of each prism is equal to the prism number times l over n. And now, the volume of a rectangular prism becomes equal to prism number l over n times prism number l over n times h over n. And we can simplify this as prism number l over n squared times h over n. So in order to find the volume of the step pyramid, we simply calculate the volume of all the rectangular prisms and add them together. So lining up the prisms, we start from the beginning and we have volume of the step pyramid is equal to 1l over n squared times h over n plus 2l over n squared times h over n plus 3l over n squared times h over n. And we will continue this process up until the last prism, which has a volume of n times l over n squared times h over n. So, having added up all the prisms together, we have this complete formula to work with. Next, we will use algebra and factor out h over n, and we will also factor out l over n squared. Therefore, the volume of the step pyramid is equal to l over n squared times h over n times the sum of integers squared. So now let's concentrate on the sum of integers squared, and this formula represents a series that contains an arbitrary amount of terms. Amazingly, this series can actually be represented by a single formula. To understand why this is true, please click on the link where I provide a geometric understanding for this formula. So now we replace the sum of integers squared with n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 over 6. Next, we will simplify our formula. First, l over n squared becomes l squared over n squared. Then we multiply this with h over n to get l squared times h over n cubed. Next, we multiply out n plus 1 times 2n plus 1, and we have 2n squared plus n plus 2n plus 1. And this simplifies to 2n squared plus 3n plus 1. Now n and n cubed cancel out, which leaves us with n squared at the bottom. Next, we switch 6 and n squared. We distribute the denominator, and we cancel out like terms. And now we have volume of the step pyramid is equal to l squared h over 6 times 2 plus 3 over n plus 1 over n squared. So now let's look back at our step pyramid. And we will increase the number of slices to infinitely many slices. Therefore, the volume of the step pyramid becomes equal to the volume of the square pyramid. Now, in terms of our formula, when we increase the number of slices of the pyramid, we are increasing the value of n in our formula. So let's take a look at what happens to both terms that contain n as it increases to infinity. As you can see, the values get smaller and smaller, and as we approach infinity, the values get so small that they actually become equal to zero. So 3 over n plus 1 over n squared becomes 0 plus 0. And what we're left with is l squared h over 6 times 2. And this simplifies to l squared h over 3. Now, l squared actually represents the area of the base of the pyramid. Therefore, we replace l squared with b, which is area of the base. And finally, we have 1 over 3 area of the base times height, which gives us the volume of a squared pyramid.
4 over 3 pi r cubed gives you the volume of a sphere. But where does the formula come from?
Around 200 BC, Archimedes devised a method for calculating pi by method of exhaustion. First, we create a circle with a radius of 1/2.